Hey everybody, Flip and Annie here, founders of the Freedom Real Estate Group family of companies, and welcome to another episode of our podcast, which is called
Freedom Through Passive Income.
See, I had to change the thing there. I like that. Anyway, welcome to another episode. And this is the this is our 12-part series called Our Journey. this is day four. Or number four, not day four, number four of our journey. And this one is titled, What is a Subject to / Wraparound Mortgage?
Yes.
And this is, I can't wait to explain it or go into this one. But, you know, we've talked about, you know, how we were working on cruise ships. And then we went into, you know, we went into the art world. And then you went into the insurance and then mortgage business. And then we both went into real estate. And then we became realtors.
Yep.
And we didn't like it. And so then we went into real estate investing, and so now this is the second stage of our real estate investing
experience.
But one thing that I forgot to mention yesterday is when we talked about, you know, what is it that you asked there, the access to capital, and I said we didn't need any, and so one of the things, and this is the story that I like to tell, is we went to Sam's Club. For $5, we got a ream of paper, a really bright colored paper. And we took a white piece of paper and wrote, hey, we happen to be in your neighborhood and we're looking for a couple more houses to buy. Give us a call if you're interested or if you know somebody interested in selling their house. And then we signed a Danny or Danielle or whatever. We always put a woman's voice or a woman's name on it. And we rolled it up. We copied that on this colored paper. And then we walked neighborhoods every morning. Mm-hmm. And we would just walk in and put it indoors. And we put it on people's front doors or, you know, because a lot of people don't use garages in Texas because that's where they store everything. They don't put their cars there. So anyway, so we put them on everybody's front door. And there was a lady on my side of the street. And I just went, oh no, there's a woman, and I could see her. She's ready to talk to me. And so I immediately went to the other side of the street, and Danny came over to my side of the street, and she hit the woman head on. And I'm trying to listen, but you know, but I'm probably hiding behind a car, and I'm trying to listen. And next thing you know, Danny's walking back across the street, just with a big smile on her face. And I'm like, what just happened? And she says, well, lady said, what are you doing? She goes, well, we're in a raising values campaign and we're trying to find some houses to buy in the neighborhood to keep the values of the neighborhood up. And the lady's like, oh, well, this person over here is looking to sell it. This person over here is like, I'm like, raising values campaign. I'm writing that down. But I'll never forget that because I was chicken. I ran to the other side of the street. But anyway, so we were doing mortgage assignments. And like we had wrapped up yesterday, where we were selling an unsellable house to an unloanable buyer. Mm-hmm. This was 2009, 2010 area. And we were getting a fee for this. So it was like wholesaling a subject to property. And then somebody said, well, why don't you guys do subject to, you know, and wraparound, which is wraparound mortgage, which is called in layman's terms or in the jargon for real estate investors, is just called a sub to wrap. Mm-hmm. And why don't you do those? And then you could be making monthly cash flow. Mm-hmm. And we're like,
We like cash flow.
I like cash flow. so I'll leave it at that, and then you can.
Oh, so explain. I'm going to define them because yesterday's episode.
I don't. I don't define things.
He just kind of kept on going to the stores. I'm like, and nobody knows what you're talking about here, babe.
Bull in a china store. I'm just going through.
So what is a subject to? A subject to means I'm going to purchase your house, Flip. Subject to the existing mortgage.
Right.
So that's really all that means, is I'm going to essentially take over his mortgage. That's it. Mm-hmm. Subject to the existing mortgage, I want to buy your house.
Yep.
And then a wraparound mortgage means I now want to sell the house to Joe, and I'm going to wrap the mortgage, the existing mortgage, mm-hmm. with a new mortgage. So if Flip's house was $140,000 loan balance and his mm-hmm. payments are, let's just say, $1,200 a month, mm-hmm. Then that's now my responsibility, right? Because I bought your house subject to that mortgage. Mm-hmm. Now Joe over here, I want Joe to buy it for $160,000, this house. I want mm-hmm. him to buy the house for $160,000, which gives me a $20,000 gap between what I was willing to take it mm-hmm. off Flip's hands for. And I want Joe to pay $1,400 a month, so I get $200 a month in cash flow. Mm-hmm. So I just bought Flip's house subject to, I just sold it to Joe with a wraparound mortgage to allow me to have $20,000 of equity in the middle, or cash, because it wasn't really equity at the time, but it will turn into equity, and $200 of cash flow a month.
Right.
So that's a subject to wraparound mortgage, and in the jargon is, I did a sub 2 wrap,
right.
And people understand what that meant.
Right, and this is different than a mortgage assignment, because a mortgage assignment, you were just strictly taking this mortgage from this guy and or gal and giving it to this person. It's just straight across.
For a fee, and you stepped out.
Yeah,
you were not in the middle.
You took a fee, but this guy was paying $1,200, this guy is paying
$1,200. Yeah, exactly.
That's a mortgage assignment. You're just assigning the mortgage, but the sub 2 wrap, that was when we got to change things and got to create cash flow for us.
Yes. So we really liked that idea. And so here's some of the pros. Was that the seller was able to get a higher price. We were able to pay a higher price because we were just taking over an existing loan that was already there. We didn't have to get approved for it. Mm-hmm. We just had to say, hey, Flip, this mortgage makes sense to us. We're willing to make the payments and we're willing to buy the house. So Flip won, we won by being able to do that.
Yep. Another one, again, it's the least worst option. Yep. You got all these options of what the seller can do with the property. This one's the least worst one.
Yes. Now we're in the middle. So that was a pro for us because we were getting the cash flow. It was a pro for Flip because remember a con when we were talking about mortgage assignments was Flip was having to depend on Joe. Mm-hmm. Now Flip is having to depend on me. I'm saying, I'm the investor. I'm buying it from you. I'll worry about Joe.
And Flip's the seller. I was like, wow, this is awesome.
Yeah. In this scenario, right now Flip is the seller.
Right.
So he's depending on me because I'm going to stay in the middle. I'm going to sell it to Joe. I'm going to get the cash flow. But if Joe defaults, I'm going to take care of it. So that was a pro for me and a pro for Flip in this situation.
And now the buyers have ownerships. You know, there's no tenants. There's no toilets, you know, which is just... incredible.
Yes. Again, it helped avoid the foreclosures on the market. Mm-hmm. We talked about that in the last episodes. We won't go into deep detail of it, but the market tends to go down in value the more foreclosures there are. So we just stopped Flip from having to go through a foreclosure or a short sale if he was the seller in this scenario.
Yep. And then if the buyer defaults, then we handle it.
Yeah.
I mean, there was numerous times where we actually, because we just got the fee for marrying these two people together.
Yes.
This person defaulted. We had to go in and get them out. Yep. Well, I'm going to go in there and get them out because then I'm going to put another one in there and get another fee.
Yes, exactly.
I think we even have a picture of me standing at the courthouse steps. I'll have to find that picture. I'll see if I can put it on this video. Of me standing on the courthouse steps reading a foreclosure because we had to foreclose on somebody.
Yep, that's right. And then the buyer gets ownership when they couldn't have otherwise. So again, his line, Flip's line about selling unsellable houses to unloanable buyers. Mm-hmm. When we found Joe, the buyer, to go ahead and take over this, you know, or have this wraparound mortgage that we had created, he couldn't get a loan otherwise. So he was super excited to be able to, you know, pay a fee to be able to get into this property and have this opportunity to have home ownership.
Yep. And now the cons in this, because there are some cons, finding a good third-party servicing. Now, we needed a third-party servicing because when the new buyer comes in, we're not going to say, okay, listen, your mortgage is actually $1,200, but $200 needs to get sent to us. Mm-hmm. So write us a different check. And, you know, we don't even mess around with that. They send the $1,400 to the third-party servicing company. Then the third-party servicing company sends it to the bank, what the bank gets, and then they send us the remainder.
Yeah.
And so finding a good one, because we went through a few.
Yeah, we did go through. Another con was the sellers who decided to change their mind years later. So they tell you that if you're an active investor, passive investors, you probably don't have to worry about this as much. I haven't heard of a passive investor ever getting sued. If you're an active investor, you have to understand that you have not been in real estate long enough until you've gotten sued. You're going to get sued in real estate. It's just one of those facts. Mm-hmm. And so we were like, okay, well, I understand that. Well, we're going to do everything right. We've got high ethics and integrity. And like, you know, we study, we surround ourselves with people who know what they're doing so that we're doing it right and not wrong. So we were okay with that. Well, we did get sued. And I think we got sued 3 times. Mm-hmm. We won every single time. That's still a con. It cost us money to win. It cost us mental energy to win.
Yeah.
So it stinks. This is one of those episodes where we're talking about short sales and mortgage assignments and subject to and wraparound mortgage. There's a lot of legalities around doing these types of transactions, and you have to have a strong legal backing if you're going to get into this type of thing. So in this part of our lives when we were doing it. We knew and understood that. We just didn't know the backlash. And the sellers had no right to come after us. They just decided 2 years down the road when their house was back up to, you know, it's now $160,000 and they only owed $140,000. And this Joe guy had paid down their mortgage for the last 2 years. They're like, I want my house back. Mm-hmm. I'm going to sue that flipping Danny who got me into it. We're like, didn't do anything wrong.
What they did was illegal.
We actually helped you. And we had attorneys and all the paperwork. And so, again, we still won, but it was a huge, huge con to have to go through all of that.
And then lastly, again, the due on sale clause.
Yep.
It rears its ugly head again.
Yes. And if you didn't listen to yesterday's episode, it's just a clause in the mortgage that gives the bank the right to call the note due. But the banks are in the business of loans, not homes.
That's
so
right.
Even if Santa Claus is writing the check, the banks are going to want to cash it. They don't care who's writing the check.
Yep.
Doesn't even
again,
matter.
It says they may have the
they
right.
They may have the right.
Exactly.
And we have attorneys.
They may for it. Anyway,
We have attorneys that have, like, they've done lots of stuff. We talked about it more in yesterday's episode. So you can just watch yesterday's episode to learn more about the due on sale clause. If you want to know, again, we're just sharing our journey with you so you can learn a little bit about all the things that we've tried and done, giving you the pros and cons. You can decide whether you want to go after them, not go after them after everybody hears about the lawsuits. You might not want to go after this one. but the five things that we talk about at the end of each of these journey episodes to help you out is, Flip, what was the risk tolerance for this?
Oh, that's a risk. Again, you're dealing. Yeah.
It costs us a lot of money to win those lawsuits.
Yep.
Time availability.
Again, you need a lot of time.
Yep.
Yep.
Knowledge.
You need a lot of knowledge to know how to do these right.
Your inner circle.
Yeah, you're going to need the inner circle, especially with this one with the attorneys.
Yep. Access to capital.
Again, still don't need that access to capital.
That's right. Yep. So that is today's journey episode of where we're at this stage of our career in real estate. In the next episode, we're going to be talking about seller financing / owner financing. It's the exact same thing. Everybody uses a different term. So I said both so that you know it's about both.
That's right. So make sure you're heading on over to our website, freedomcapitalinvestments.com, to join our investor club to see all the stuff that we're doing today. But also make sure you're hitting the like button. You're hitting the like button because
you like, again, this journey. Like,
the journey.
We're teaching you a ton. This is since 2008. Like, this is a lot of years and a lot of knowledge in our noggin that we don't even talk about anymore. Mm-hmm. So I hope you like these episodes.
Yep. Make sure you're hitting the subscribe button and the heart button and the whatever else. Make sure you're hitting buttons.
And give us a review if this is valuable.
There you go. But we like to end all of our episodes with...
Invest smart.
Live happy.
Bye, everybody.
Nothing on this show should be considered specific, personal, or professional advice. Please consult an appropriate tax, legal, real estate, financial, or business professional for individualized advice. Opinions and information on this show are not guaranteed. All investment strategies have the potential for profit or loss.